In this section, we're going to look at computing the derivative of an orthogonal rotation matrix. One of the properties of an orthogonal matrix is that its inverse is equal to its transpose. So we can write this simple relationship, R times its transpose must be equal to the identity matrix. First off, I'm going to consider the simple case of a rotation by the angle theta about the x-axis. I can take the derivative with respect to theta, and using the chain rule, I can write this. Applying this identity, I can rewrite it in this particular form, and I can simplify by introducing the symbol S to represent this expression here. The matrix S has an interesting property. If I add it to its transpose, the result will be equal to zero, and this kind of matrix is referred to as a skew-symmetric matrix. That property of the skew-symmetric matrix can also be written like this. So this kind of matrix is also sometimes referred to as an anti-symmetric matrix. These matrices are always singular, that is, their determinant is always equal to zero. Any matrix can be written as the sum of a symmetric matrix and a skew-symmetric matrix. In three dimensions, the skew-symmetric matrix has this form. It's got a very distinctive zero diagonal, and there are only three unique elements in this matrix, x, y, and z, and each of them appears with a positive sign and a negative sign. Another interesting characteristic of the skew-symmetric matrix is it's a way to write the vector cross-product relationship, as the product of a skew-symmetric matrix computed from the vector A multiplied by the vector B. So a cross-product can be turned into a matrix vector product. Here is our earlier expression for S, and I can write down an expression for a matrix which represents rotation about the x-axis by the angle theta. If I substitute these values in and simplify, I end up with a very simple matrix containing a lot of zeros, 1 and a minus 1. Recalling our earlier expression for a skew-symmetric matrix, this matrix that I've just written down, I can write as a skew-symmetric matrix of the vector 1, 0, 0. So the derivative of a rotation matrix with respect to theta is given by the product of a skew-symmetric matrix multiplied by the original rotation matrix. I can perform the algebraic manipulation for a rotation around the y-axis and also for a rotation around the z-axis, and I get these expressions here, and you can clearly see some kind of pattern. Now let's consider the general case, a rotation about the vector L by an angle theta. And it can be shown that this is equal to the product of a skew-symmetric matrix computed from the vector L multiplied by the original rotation matrix. If I now multiply both sides of the expression by d theta dt, that's the rate of change of theta, I can write an expression like this. What this says is that the time derivative of a general rotation matrix, a rotation of theta, about the vector L, is equal to a skew-symmetric matrix computed on the vector omega multiplied by the original rotation matrix. Omega in this case is the angular velocity vector. It is the rate of change of angle multiplied by the vector direction about which the rotation is occurring.